anyone who is worried about the safety involved here, your data shows, look, we should be pursuing this path.
Yeah, so in an early paper, just looking at the kinds of technologies that auto manufacturers already have, we expected about an 85% crash reduction and fatality reduction and crash cost reduction, which is a lot of money because Americans already lose about $3,000 a year per capita every year to crash costs. And what we've already seen is Waymo is hitting that target on the streets of San Francisco, Phoenix, and LA, where it's been comparing itself to the other drivers that are on those exact same streets.
Of course, cost to vehicle owners, cost of life as well, car, is something that just everyone is so focused on. But there has to be regulation that keeps up. China is going at this full speed. So is Asia. We're just talking about how Baidu is rolling out across Singapore, Malaysia. Are we keeping pace with how quickly the innovation could change here in the US?
Well, I think so, thanks to Tesla. But of course, they also have a gigafactory in China. And so China may have access to all of that intellectual property and be able to mimic it quickly to catch up with Tesla, with a Chinese-based company.
Okay, so thanks to Tesla, thanks to Waymo, thanks to Zooks, who we had on earlier in the week. There is plenty of companies that are showing that it can be done. Just remind us of also not the cost implications from an insurance perspective, but more broadly, how much easier, how much more cost efficient will it be to make these vehicles? Because look, Zooks is saying it's going to make 10,000 in the next few years or so per year in their new facility. But all of these means they're pretty expensive pieces of equipment as it stands.
Right. So people are estimating that the Waymo vehicles right now, which are on a very expensive Jaguar I-Pace, which is a suggested retail price of $75,000, I think. So add another $75,000 to get all of the LiDAR and everything else installed. But if you can install it all directly on the assembly line in one coherent piece, the cost comes down a bit. And of course, Waymo's not in the business of actually manufacturing the vehicles. Mm-hmm. And Tesla is. And if you go to the Tesla website, I think they're offering the technology for $8,000 up front, plus another $100 a month. And so that starts to sound pretty reasonable. And we do expect those costs to come down long term to maybe under $5,000 off the top. And if you have to have a monthly check fee or something, so they're updating, to new standards each month, then there might be another $50 fee on top of that, I suppose.
Talk to us, therefore, about how FSD seems to work at the moment, because we hear on both sides of the equation, many love it, many feel that it is incredibly efficient. Others say there are still so many holes, so many ways in which that it underperforms, we cannot roll it out yet in the United States.
Well, it's already out there. So a lot of us have friends and neighbors and people just alongside us in the traffic stream. And you may not notice because there is somebody in that driver's seat, but they are in FSD mode. And so I believe they've driven billions of miles already, whereas the Waymo fleet has gone about 60 million miles of rider only, so nobody in the driver's seat. And that's the big jump here, is that they're tweaking the algorithm so that the car will be able to move without somebody in that driver's seat, and will do a lot of the parking, which they're not doing right now for the owners of FSD, who paid that $8,000 plus the $100 a month, and of course have to be in that driver's seat, legally have to be a licensed driver, and have to keep their eyes open, much of the time. But when I was in that driver's seat, I did nothing. It was very precise. It was very impressive on very complex network here, the routes that we were taking. But it was broad daylight. And the one thing I noticed is, it does go above the posted speed limit to keep up with the traffic around it, which the Waymo vehicles don't do. And it also came, a lot. It was much more confident around pedestrians and scooters and cyclists than I would normally be as a driver myself. So that's where I'm a little bit nervous. If somebody turns around midstream, you've seen the images of scooterists falling in front of a Waymo, that would be tough. So there will be some really hard braking or maneuvering if they're going to avoid those kinds of crashes. So that's something I'd be watching out for.